I got sick of modern music, and so I just started going back to my 80s roots of being it when I was like, you know, younger, let's just say. And so I kind of dug up some influences I didn't know I really had, like
really?
The Bangles and Go-Go's and Blondie and stuff, and just kind of changed my songwriting style.
Wow, yeah, it fits like a glove. Figured you have been really well versed in it. How about you?
We are well versed in it. We all grew up with it, but it wasn't something that we consciously attached ourselves to until this record, until these songs came out of Anna miraculously, and it was just kind of
birth
like
to them.
Songs came out of Anna. Where do they come out of?
We don't want to talk about it on television.
You're the one who's always like been the person writing the songs, right?
Uh-huh.
And then the band has always sort of supported the shell, the skeleton of the song. Does it change a lot from when you bring the song to the band?
Some did and some didn't, you know? It really depends. Some were just little sketches of songs where we'd go in and, you know, try out a bunch of stuff, and then others were pretty much done, and we would just realize that song the way it is.
In the early days, none of us were that. None of us was, I think that's the proper English, none of us was that developed in terms of, you know, we weren't that sophisticated in terms of our arrangements and whatnot. Things were pretty simple. So we just kind of would throw it together, you know, whatever we did that day, that was kind of how the song was. So I'm entering into more of like a Carole King phase. So it's pop, but it's a little more like, you know, frizzy haired. It's going to get a little more introspective.
Yeah.
I like the frizzy haired analogy.
I'm going to have frizzy hair and like a baby in a flowered skirt.
And a muumuu.
Yeah, muumuu.
And I'm going to be shirtless with a vest and really long hair and a mustache.
We're going to have to get married.
We'll probably get married and divorced during the course of the next record.
Perfect. And we'll have to gain a lot of weight.
Yeah.
I think. Big run. Like a bitch. If some things embarrass me, I know that it's probably catchy, and then I'll leave it.
Like,
maybe.
Oh, so sweet.
Yeah, kind of like that. Like, oh, I don't know about this, and then I'll leave it, and you know.
Well, for example, the first single from the record, Never Say Never, was kind of embarrassing to all of us, and we did it kind of despite ourselves.
Horrible message.
No, I mean, it turned out to be great. It means that sometimes you just have to trust your first instinct, which is what we did, and even if you feel a little funny about it, give it a little time, and time will tell you what's going to happen. For us, it, you know, jumped out as our first single, so we were glad we did it.
I have a really good time writing harmonies. I mean, it's just how I think, and it was good to find Rachel and Petra because they've been singing together their whole lives. So, you know, if I would write all these harmonies, they would immediately get it, and that would be it. Or, you know, or
so you write all the harmonies too, and they
I write a lot of them. But then also there are times when it clicks for them, like, oh, we have to do this, and you know, they have an amazing mind for it as well.
He's kissing Christian, and it's making my back hurt. He's kissing Christian.
Everybody in your band is Jewish, is that right?
Yeah, Yeah.
Yep.
And do you find that it's like is that a familiar territory? Is there something like familiar with each other just having being Jewish American?
I think there's a certain kind of humor that we all relate to and a certain kind of, I don't know what it is, a kind of spunky pessimism that kind of infiltrates a lot of what we do, and it helps. It's, you know, it's hard to know. When people get around us, they kind of slip into it pretty easily, too. We have a lot of converts. Yeah. Our new guitar player, Kenny, who's touring with us, he's definitely going to convert to Judaism now after being around us.
This month.
We are?
Yep.
Okay.
It talks about your ample cleavage in the video Never Say Never.
Yeah.
Do you have that? So what happened there? Are you usually quite comfortable? Like strutting your...
What? I'm wearing this sweater in the video. How tacky. Okay, sorry, what?
Ample cleavage, is that right? There's ample cleavage in the video?
Yeah,
yeah there is.
Yeah.
I remember seeing some. So are you comfortable? Is this like a stretch for you to like strut your stuff and like ample cleavage in video?
A little bit.
Yeah.
I mean, when we started this band, I was a teenager, so I think I was a little more uncomfortable, and I didn't, you know, I still had a kid's body kind of, and so I'm a woman now. I've got, you know, I'm doing my thing. Right.
You know what? It's okay to be a woman. You know, it's important for the kids to know it is all right to be a woman, and we wanted to show that in the video.
And to be proud of your body, it's good. It's a healthy thing.
It's been good enough.